Now, we'll be seeing about the sources of energy. Okay, the topic will be today about the sources of energy. The energy sources means you can say that from those substances we can readily take out the energy, readily we can take out the energy with some process and all this thing. That is known as the sources of energy. Okay, there are some materials, some substances are there from which we can readily take out the energy, and those substances can be told, or those materials can be told as a sources of the energy. Now, in your just neighborhood or in your surroundings, you find various sources of energy. The first thing, there are many sources. Example, you can say about the coal. Okay, you can say petroleum. Petroleum means, under the petroleum it comes many type of petroleum products, sources of energy, like the petrol, the natural gas, the diesel, not the natural, yeah, natural gas is separate one, diesel, okay, then naphtha we get, and then you may say that we get the sources of energy from the solar radiation also. There is some geothermal energy, and there are other sources like hydro energy is there, hydrogen is there, and a nuclear energy is there by the fission of the nuclear energy derived from the fission of uranium-235 or it's the plutonium. Okay, plutonium-214 we can derive the nuclear energy. So these all type of substances, you know, what we know, that the coal, the petroleum, okay, the wind energy, wind, then we can say the solar energy, then the hydrogen, these all things, they are the all sources of energy. Now, under the sources of energy, we have to classify the source of energy. So you can say that energy source or sources of energy is classified in two broad categories. The first is known as renewable sources. The second one is known as the non-renewable sources. So we have the energy sources divided into two parts here. One is the renewable sources, one is the non-renewable sources. Renewable sources are those energy sources which are present in large amount, in unlimited amount, and they can be replenished by some natural process. And you can say they are not exhausted by the human activities. Okay, and you can say that these are also known as the inexhaustible sources of energy. Means exhaustive nahi ho raha hai, to aise sources of energy ko kya bolenge hum log, inexhaustible sources of energy. Okay, now this is the renewable sources of energy. In the renewable sources of energy, we are getting some sources of energy, like, you know, you can say that the solar energy. Okay, we are getting this one, that is solar energy, you know? Then we are getting the hydro energy, you know? Then we can get the energy from geothermal energy, and lots of examples are there on the basis of renewable sources of energy. Air also you can say. And there is a non-renewable sources. In the non-renewable sources, what happens, the quantity of energy that is not in a very, it is coming, it is in the form of very limited form, or there is an existence of limited form of the energy sources in the case of non-renewable sources of energy. and they are just, you know, they are exhausted by the human activities, or you can say they are also known as the exhaustible sources of the energy. The best example of these sources are, you can say, it is the coal, okay, it is the petroleum, I know, it is the coal, we have the petroleum, we have the natural gas also, okay, and we have the some fissionable materials, some fissionable materials, I know, like, you know, say, like, you can say uranium-235 or plutonium, है ना, plutonium, PLU, है ना, Ni, plutonium-214. So these are known as the non-renewable sources of the energy. Now after these two sources of energy, again energy you can classify into two types, two broad types, or two broad parts, you can say. Okay, based on the energy source classification, we have divided energy source in two types. One is the renewable source and one is the non-renewable source. Then again you can divide the energy source in two types, and that is known as the conventional sources, and this is known as the non-conventional sources. Non-conventional sources. So you can divide the energy source in two types. One is known as the conventional sources, and one is known as the non-conventional sources. Conventional sources of energy are those materials, or those materials that we derive the energy from, those materials which are readily available in our neighborhood. In our neighborhood, it is readily available. And that is known as the conventional sources of energy. बल्कि तो non-conventional sources of energy वो energy है जो अपने को readily available नहीं मिलते हैं, है ना? तो readily available बोलने से इसमें क्या आएंगे? वही आएगा इसमें, coal आएगा, petrol आएगा, है कि नहीं? इसमें क्या क्या आएंगे इसमें? इसमें वही आएगा coal, है ना? Then again we can get petroleum, है ना? Then we can get natural gas, ठीक है, फिर इसमें कुछ कुछ मिलेंगे जैसे मान लो बायोमास, है ना, एक्सेट्रा. और नॉन कन्वेंशनल में जैसे मान लो कि सोलर एनर्जी, फिर ये टाइडल एनर्जी, फिर जियोथर्मल एनर्जी, है ना, देन वी हैव न्यूक्लियर एनर्जी. So these all sources of energy which are not readily available to us, because for this particular energy sources we require a technology. Without technology we cannot derive this type of sources of energy, but for these sources of energy we do not require any technology, because these are been sold in our neighborhood. We can purchase petrol, we can purchase coal, we can purchase natural gas, we can purchase the biomass, okay. In the next lecture, I will tell you some details about the energy sources.